हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू परफॉर्म एक्सपेरिमेंट नंबर 5। योर एम ऑफ द एक्सपेरिमेंट इज यू आर गिवन 0.09 नॉर्मल KMnO4 सॉल्यूशन। डिटरमाइन द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ गिवन एक्स नॉर्मल ऑक्सैलिक एसिड इन टर्म्स ऑफ नॉर्मलिटी एंड ग्राम्स पर लीटर। सो द रिक्वायरमेंट्स विच यू नीडेड for this experiment is butyrate, here you have 25 ml butyrate, pipette and it's 10 ml pipette, funnel, conical flask and beakers. The chemicals which you required for this experiment is 0.09 normal KMnO4 solution, X normal oxalic acid and dilute H2SO4 solution. So let's start the procedure. First of all, you have to clean all the apparatus with water. So here we are first clean butyrate. After that, conical flask. Pipette. Now we rinse the butyrate with KMnO4 solution. Here we are rinsing the butyrate. Now we rinse pipette with oxalic acid solution like this way. Now we will fill the butyrate with 0.09 normal KMnO4 solution. So as you can see, KMnO4 has dark purple color, so our solution is colored solution, so we have to set upper meniscus to the zero level. Now we will take X normal oxalic acid with the help of pipette and transfer into a clean conical flask. Now we will add 1 test tube of dilute H2SO4 solution. And now we will heat the contents of the flask to 70 to 80 degrees Celsius. So when the vapors start condensing on the neck of conical flask, we assume that we reach 70 to 80 degrees temperature. So now immediately this hot solution titrate against KMnO4 solution, and here we are not using any indicator because the KMnO4, it act as a self indicator. So as you can see, we get permanent pink color, which is our end point. So now we will see our burette reading. We have colored solution, so we have to see upper meniscus of the solution. So as you can see, our upper meniscus is at 9, so our burette reading is 9 ml. Now with the same process, you have to repeat the titration to get a constant reading. After finish your experiment, you have to clean all the apparatus with water again. So now we will write down our burette reading in our observation table, right? So here we have first initial reading. Initial reading means what? Initial reading means the starting point of burette, right? अपने starting point of burette आपने कहाँ पर set किया था वो आपका initial reading होगा and that will be your 0.0 ml, right? So after performing the titration, you get your final reading as a 9 ml, right? So here you have to write down 9 ml, right? And difference will be your final minus initial. So here you have 9.0 minus 0.0, you have 9 ml, right? So as you perform a second time titration and third time titration, we assume that we get the same reading, right? So you have to write down in observation table that 9 ml, right, is your final reading. So as you performing a third time, three times titration, so you get 9 ml. So your constant reading will be 9 ml, right? And this value you have to put down in your statement, right? So here what you have, 9 ml of 0.09 normal KMnO4 is required for complete oxidation of 10 ml. X normal oxalic acid, right? Now we will see calculation. So again we have a simple formula for the calculation. it is N1V1 is equals to N2V2, where N1 is equals to normality of KMnO4, which is already given to you in your aim, right? And it is 0.09 normal. Second, you have V1. V1 is equals to volume of KMnO4, and it will be your burette reading, right? So burette reading, or you can say your final reading, right? And it will be your 9 ml. N2 is equals to normality of oxalic acid, which you have to find out. V2 is equals to volume of oxalic acid, and it is 10 ml, right? So now we have a formula. N2 is equals to N1 V1 upon V2. So here you have 0.09 into Br upon 10, and you get 0.09 into 9, right? 9 ml is your burette reading. So you get 0.081 normal, right? So normality of oxalic acid, you will find 0.081 normal, right? After that, what? After that, you have to find out grams per liter, right? You have to find out grams per liter of oxalic acid. So you have to know about normality of oxalic acid and equivalent of oxalic acid. Normality of oxalic acid, you have already find it, right? And it will be your 0.081. And equivalent weight of oxalic acid is 63. Your grams per liter will be 5.103 grams. It means that in 1 liter solution, you have 5.103 grams oxalic acid is dissolved. And finally, you have a result table, right? Solution which you have to find out its normality in grams per liter is oxalic acid, right? And what did you find its normality? It's 0.081 normal, right? And its grams per liter will be your 5.103 grams. So this is your final result table.